I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the high-tense desert, I'll travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. For your glory, I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. Lord, if I find
hallelujah. Come on, if you would, just stand to your feet and just worship with us a little bit today. Come on, just somebody just lift up your voice and say, Lord, it's for your glory. Hallelujah. I'll do anything. We do not own the rights to this music. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For your glory, I'll do anything. Come on, put that on the screen, somebody. Just say, for your glory, I'll do anything. Put it in the chat this morning. Good morning. Father, we bless you. California's in the house. God bless you. I'll do anything for you. Come on, somebody just give God a wave offering if you can. Just put a hand up in the air and say, Lord, it's for your glory. It's for your glory. I will do anything. Yes. Yes, Lord. Mama. Hallelujah. Is that anybody's testimony today? I just want to be where the Lord is. I don't know about y'all, but I just want to be where God is this morning. Hallelujah.
Gotta be where you are.
Well, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his name. Come on, y'all. Let's give God some praise.
Hallelujah.
In this place.
Hallelujah. Glory.
If he's been good to you, if he's been kind to you. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
Let's
bless
praise
God.
Him this morning.
He's
hallelujah.
Good. He's
we
a
bless
good
you
God.
This morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We know that we
hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
We do not
glory,
own
glory.
The rights to that music. That is not our music. Amen.
Amen. But
hallelujah.
It sure did
but
bless us.
But we're
going
to get our praise on this morning. Come on, be seated in the presence of the Lord if you can. It's good to see each and every one of you today. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Today seems like it might be Grandchildren Day because I think I see Josiah. Is that Josiah in the house? Who is that? That's Jaden in
Jaden.
The house.
Good morning.
God bless you, Jaden. Hallelujah. You got some grandkids in the house today. My grandkids are here today.
Amen.
So we just thank God for everybody today. Lottie Dottie, and thank God for everybody. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for everybody. Thank y'all for coming. Thank y'all for coming online today. I ask you guys, if you are coming on Facebook, if you would, please go ahead and share this broadcast today. Amen. I got a word for y'all today. Amen.
Amen.
I have got a word for you all this morning. Hallelujah. Well, good to see you, First Lady. You're looking good.
Amen. Right back at you.
You're slimming down so much, they're going to say, I'm not feeding you no more. Hallelujah. But you're looking good. Looking good.
I'm
hallelujah.
Doing what I can with what I got.
Sound just says, for your glory this
amen.
Morning. Amen.
Truly,
hallelujah.
Truly.
All right,
that
good to see you out there,
really
Greg.
Blesses me.
Greg Millen, my brother from another mother. Amen. Good to see Greg this morning. Of course, my cousin is in the house from Las Vegas. I said California
keep
earlier.
California.
When she been,
we
she
might know. Be speaking prophetically, though. You never can
Amen.
Tell.
Yes. Good morning, Erica Covington.
I see Sister Covington out there. Good morning.
Everybody. It's good to see everybody in the house this
Brother
morning.
Brother Trey Wilson, good morning
Deacon
to you.
Mason doing double this morning. Not only is he... not only is Deacon Mason in the house, but he on Facebook too. Amen. He's just doing everything today.
Amen.
Back there working the sounds
Amen.
On Facebook.
God bless you.
He's just doing it all. He's just seeing his pastor can pastor see it all. I'm doing the best I can, y'all. It's a little rough this morning. We are our musician. We got our own musician. We back to our Facebook musicians.
Amen.
Thank you, Tasha Cobb. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Tasha Cobb. The great Tasha Cobb is in the house. She's in the house via YouTube. Amen. God bless
Good
you.
Good morning to the Dotsons and the Deloach family. Hey, Mother Deloach.
Yes.
Love you.
Love you so much.
Amen.
Amen. What you got, First Lady?
So we just want to welcome you to our live broadcast. We are here live at our sanctuary, 5430 South Washington.
Yes.
In the great capital city of Lansing, Michigan. We're welcoming you to just join in to this worship experience. This is 60 minutes or less of a worship experience. We have not stopped that concept since the pandemic. It has been working.
Yeah.
So we just want to welcome whether you are face-to-face with us or whether you're Facebook Live.
Yes.
We just welcome you today. We want you to know that Antioch is a church that is empowered by love, edified by faith. And committed to excellence. We are kingdom seekers. We believe that if we put the kingdom of God first, that everything that we have need of, God is going to work that out for us. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
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 So let's get right to our psalm today, Psalm 119. I'm going to be reading verses 33 through 38. It says, "Teach me, Lord, the way of your decrees, that I may follow it to the end. Give me understanding so that I may keep your law and obey it with all my heart.
Yes.
Direct me in the path of your commands, for there I find delight. Turn my heart toward your statutes and not toward selfish gain. Turn my eyes away from worthless things. Preserve my life according to your word.
Yes.
Fulfill your promise to your servant that you may be feared. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearing and reading of his holy word." And as we Amen. Think about this psalm, it for me, it just was a reminder of God setting us free. He's calling us out, not just calling us out, but he's calling us out to serve him.
My Lord.
So our freedom today comes with a price.
Yes.
And that price, saints of God, is keeping God first in our lives and letting him guide our path. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Well, thank you, First Lady. That was powerful, powerful, powerful. I love those psalms. And people love those psalms that you read to us
Amen.
Each and every Sunday morning. Amen. I got thrown off this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, man, my family. All my family just coming in and all over the place today.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God for the Blackwells, amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Elder Blackwell is in the house today. I'm going to have to preach good today. I'm going to have to preach good today. Amen. The theologian is in the house today. Hallelujah. Bless y'all so much.
Amen.
Amen. With their beautiful family. Hallelujah. I know I married them, don't y'all?
Yes, you did.
Amen. Hallelujah. Well, today is a good day. Amen. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice, and we will be glad in it. Amen. It is time for our announcements today. Hallelujah. First Lady, you got some birthdays for us today?
Yes, we have some birthdays. So do you want me to kick off prayer first?
Yeah, go ahead and pray, and then we'll do our birthdays.
All right. Would you just stand to your feet with me as we pray? Thank you, Father. God, we are
Hallelujah.
Just so grateful.
Thank you for your grace.
We are so humbled.
Yes.
Here we are.
Yes.
Months later.
My Lord.
You are still on the throne.
Yes.
You are still the great I am.
Yes.
The creator of heaven and earth.
Yes, Lord.
And all that is in the sea.
Yes, Lord.
And we are still in awe of you, God.
Yes, Lord.
Your mighty hand of provision, protection, peace, promise, has been on us continually, Lord. And we cannot praise you or thank you enough. We thank you, Father God, for keeping us in our right minds. Thank you, Lord God, for your blessing of our bodies, our healing, and our health. We claim it, and we thank you for it today.
Yes, Lord.
We ask, Lord God, that you will be in the midst of this worship experience,
Lord God.
That you will be with our pastor as he brings forth a word of encouragement, even a challenging word, Lord God, to remind us of who you are in our life, Father, to remind us of how your word is here for us to stand on it and to depend on it, God. And so, Father God, we just invite you not only into this sanctuary, but we invite you into the sanctuary of our hearts today.
Yes.
Have your way with each and every one of us. Those that are face-to-face, those that are Facebook Live, whether it's in this country or any other continent, Lord God, we ask you to have your way. We declare and decree that every need is met according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus.
Yes,
there is no lack, only overflow.
Yes.
And you have positioned us, Lord God, to be generous, Father. We thank you for it now, Father. For all of our needs truly have been met by you.
Yes.
And so, Father, we thank you for your mighty and merciful hand upon your people.
Yes.
Have your way in this place today.
Yes.
And we give you, we promise to give,
give you glory.
All the glory, all the honor, and all of the praise.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Would
Amen.
You put your hands
Come
together
on,
and give
God,
God a
praise
hand clap
in this
of praise?
Place.
Oh, you
Hallelujah.
Can do better than that. He's worthy. Look back over your life. Hallelujah. Look back over your life and give him some praise. Glory,
Hallelujah.
Glory, glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Be seated. You may be seated.
Be seated if you can. Amen.
Thank you, God.
We have some August birthdays. Amen. I was trying to get to our August birthdays already. We have some August birthdays. We have a lot of August
yes,
birthdays,
we
as
do.
A matter of fact. Hallelujah. Who we got, First Lady?
So we have Phyllis Anderson, Kesey Farmer, Devin Johnson, Erica Newby, Rhonda Miller. Just yesterday we had Ernesto Rocha, our grandson,
yes.
had a birthday. Ernest Dotson, Valita
yes.
Jacobs. Coming up we have Elliot Jackson, Roscoe Hassel, Darren Washington, Michelle Brown on the 14th. On the 15th we have Bryson Singleton. The 16th, we have Monica Edmonds. And on the 27th, we have Frederick Smith and Donjo Christian Franklin.
Amen.
Amen. So we had a list for August for sure.
Well, happy birthday to
happy
all
birthday.
Of the August birthdays. God bless y'all.
Amen.
So glad you guys was born in August in that hot month.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Did you have something else?
Yeah, just when we get to the pantry, I'll just kind of share our pantry.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we had a great time yesterday. Our family actually got a chance to come out and see the whole thing in operation. And
yes.
just want to say thank you again to our leaders of the pantry and all the volunteers, Sister Petra, Sister Carolyn, and Sister Gina for just coordinating such a great effort. We served over 75 people yesterday in our pantry. It truly was a blessing.
Yes.
Our next pantry is going to be on September 11th. We pushed it up Saturday because of the holiday. So on September 11th, we will be dispersing again to our community.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And they did a phenomenal job. Amen. My grandson, well, the grandkids, they started jumping in, putting baskets in
yes.
people's cars.
It was
it's
beautiful.
Always good. Amen. It is. It is
and
always
you have
good
to teach
see.
Your young people to think about somebody else, you know, because
right.
it's such a temptation, especially in the world, to just focus inward. But it really is a blessing to serve people.
Amen. First
Amen.
Lady, I just want you to know I'm standing up because my chair keeps sinking down. I don't know
okay,
what's going
so
on with that.
Let me stand up. So
so I'm just telling you now, that's why I'm standing up. I'm not trying to do nothing special, y'all. But my chair keeps... I keep going down. I'm like, what is that all about?
One of them Austin Power moments.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So we thank God for the pantry and all that and all the people that participated therein. Amen. Amen. And then also we want to just say to each and every person that comes to prayer, our prayer is on Tuesday at 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. So if you are if you're coming online at 6 a.m. and 6 p.m., all you got to do is just come on and say, praise the Lord, and then somebody will take it from there. Amen? That's all you got to do. Hallelujah. Somebody give God some praise for a prayer line. Amen. Well,
good to see so many people in the sanctuary today. And praise the Lord.
And God bless you all, because what we, you know, they've kind of changed some things a little bit. And so masks are appreciated, and so people are wearing their masks, whether they're vaccinated or not. We kind of changed up a little bit, and so folks been wearing masks. And so thank you all for wearing your mask and being so obedient to keeping one another healthy.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the mask is something else, because the mask makes you not know if you want to clap or not. But you can clap. Amen. Hallelujah. You can clap. Matter of fact, I can't see if y'all smiling or not. So if y'all smiling, just wave at me like that. So I know that y'all smiling, you know. Hallelujah. Well, it's giving time. Y'all ready to give? Come on, y'all. The Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. It says that men will give into your bosom. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I don't know about you, but this has been a season of the Lord showing his blessings on our behalf. Amen?
Amen.
Showing his blessings on our behalf. This has been a season where it seemed like during COVID-19 that things would get worse, but for many people, things just got better.
Amen.
Amen? Somebody say out loud, say things are still getting better.
Yes, things are still getting better.
Come on, say it out loud. Say it like you mean it. Say things are still getting better.
Isn't it interesting how God will prove himself in the hardest of times?
Yes.
Then he will show up so big and strong.
He'll show up. He'll show up big and strong. So if you are, if you have Cash App, it's the money sign, capital A-N-T-I-O-C-H, 5430. If you're sowing through PayPal, you got to go to the website, www.antiochoflansing.org, then follow the giving prompts from there. If you want to do an old school give, you can still do that as well. You can send it to the P.O. Box. P.O. Box 80346 48908 is the zip code. If you're in the sanctuary and you want to sow just a flat seed in the sanctuary, write a check or whatever. You make the check payable at Antioch Church. We got some envelopes in the back. And all I ask is that you not lick the envelope. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Don't lick the envelope. Just put it in the envelope. And stick the other part inside the envelope. Y'all know how to do it, and then drop it in the and drop it in the basket, and then you can get up and you can sow it at any time. Amen.
Amen.
Do y'all ready? Y'all ready to give? Come on. This is the last time I'm gonna tell you to stand up. No, it's not. I got one more time to tell you to stand up. Hallelujah. Come on, just lift your offering up. Come on, stand up if you will. Just stretch your legs a little bit. Lift your offering up. Say, Father God.
Father God,
say, I thank you.
I thank you
for blessing me
with this seed.
Lord, I sow my seed
by faith.
And I fully expect a 100-fold return
on my giving.
Lord,
you took care of us
throughout the pandemic. And Lord, We believe
that the best
is yet to come.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
How many people know that the best is yet to come in Jesus' name?
Amen.
Hallelujah. We thank God for you. Amen. So they're giving online. Amen. They're sowing online. Hallelujah. Who is that? Oh, Sarah Jo Crosby is in the house online.
God
y'all
bless
could be seated.
You.
Sarah Jo Crosby is online. Hallelujah.
Okay, so I'll see you on the other side.
Well, amen. I'll see you on the other side.
Like
amen.
We're rolling today.
We just rolling on through. Amen. I got plenty of time, y'all.
All right. I got plenty of time.
And I'm going to do that, y'all. I'm going to take my time today. I got something to give y'all today. Amen. Thank God for you. Amen. First Lady. I think First Lady was rolling through trying to get to the grandbabies. You know, grandfathers, we love our grandkids. But, man, it's something about them grandmothers. Amen. Grandmothers, boy, they really love them grandkids. Hallelujah. Well, turn with me. Turn with me to Mark's gospel. Mark chapter number 4. Turn with me to Mark chapter number 4. And then we're going to take a look at verse 35 through 40. Mark chapter number 4. Mark chapter number 4. We're going to take a look at verse 39 through 40. 35 through 40. 35 through 40. Hallelujah. Y'all can stand. I got a couple of y'all standing. So if y'all want to, just come on. Just that's the last time I'm going to tell you stand. Then y'all can just be seated. Boy, we had a good time on last week. Amen. We're going to have another good time on today. But boy, we had a good time on last week. And I thank God that people are beginning to come back. I was telling my family today that there are a couple of places that people really were struggling with when we first started with this, Rita. There were people that were struggling with coming back to work, coming back to school, and coming back to church. Them was the three places that folk was just struggling with, amen? Now that people got them last vacations in, man, they got them last vacations in, man. So now they like, oh, well, might as well go back to work now. Might as well go back to school now. So everybody's starting to get comfortable. Did y'all find Mark chapter number 4? All right, let's take a look at verse number 35 through 40. Y'all ready? And it reads, "And the same day when evening was come, he saith unto them, Let us pass over unto the other side. And when he had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship," watch this, "asleep on a pillow. And awake, and they say unto him," they wake him, "and they say unto him, Master, carest not that we perish? And he arose, and he rebuked the wind, and he said unto the sea, Peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm." Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for this word. I pray, Lord God, that this word would light up the path of the believer. Pray, Lord God, none of me, but I pray, Lord God, all of thee. I pray, Lord God, for the hearers of this word, that they might not sin against thee. I pray, Lord God, that they would take this word and hide it, literally hide it in their hearts. Father God, I pray that they would take it to a dying world, Lord God, and just sow it into somebody's life and let somebody know that they might have some scars, but God is still in the blessing business. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen. Somebody shake your word at me. Say, this is my word. Say, if I receive this word with my mind only, then this word is dead to me. But if I receive this word with my spirit over my mind, then this word is life to me. I do not need any religious form or fashion. I need life in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. If you need life in Jesus' name, just say it like this. Say, I know you got your mask on, so you can look at somebody. Look at them and just say it so that they can hear you. You might have to say it a little louder because you got your mask on. Say, I'm scarred, but I'm blessed. Come on, say it out loud. Say, I'm scared, but I'm blessed. Amen. Be seated in the presence of the Lord if you can. Hallelujah. Jesus begins this chapter, and he's getting in the boat, and he has been preaching to the people. Elder Blackwell, the Bible taught us, says that he taught us many things while he was in the water in that ship preaching. He got into the ship, and then he went to the other side. Somebody say the other side. Jesus, he picked his team and his team of disciples, and he taught his disciples many things. But one of the things that I love about him picking his disciples was the fact that he picked a core group of fishers. These guys were fishers. These guys understood fundamentally, they understood how to believe. Fundamentally, they understood how to operate by faith. Fundamentally. Even when we are chosen, it doesn't mean, watch this, that things are always going to be easy. Okay, I'm going to talk to some real people today. Just because you've been chosen by God, just because you have given your life to Christ, just because you are a born-again believer, it doesn't mean that things are always going to be easy. It's going to be some difficult decisions to make along the way. Anything that we do, there is a possibility, watch this, Deacon Mason, that a storm will arise. Y'all going to talk to me today? I'm just going to be real to some people, because sometimes we think that once we become believers that then life is hunky-dory and we never have any types of things in our life. But when you become a believer, you better understand something. Storms will arise. So today I want to teach from this concept that we're all familiar with. Scars. All of us are familiar with scars because we all have been scarred. We all have scars. What is interesting to me is that scars vary in their severity. Some people have a scar from childhood and it was just a scrape, but it left a scar. You remember it because it left a scar. Some people have some scars that were from a wound that was a little deeper, and you had to have some stitches. Left a scar. Are y'all still with me? About a year ago, maybe 2 years ago, Elder Blackwell, I was over in the fellowship hall, and Sister Tresha Terry was standing there with me, and we were getting ready to teach the kids how to make smoothies. We were teaching them. I think your children was there. We're teaching them how to make smoothies and how to live a healthy life. And so I was rinsing the blender. I was rinsing the blender. And when I rinsed the blender slipped and cut the tip of my finger. That left a scar. Left a scar. And what I didn't know, man, was that when I went to the doctor, I didn't realize how many nerve endings are on the tips of your fingers. And so when I walked in, I got some time, I'm just gonna tell the story. So when I walked into the doctor's office, I went to emergency first lady, said, that matter of fact, Sister Blackwell said, put some pressure on it. You remember that, Sister Jean? She said, put some pressure on it. You're not squeezing hard enough. I said, okay, all right. So I put some pressure on it, and that thing was still just bleeding. And so when I went into the doctor's office, I went into urgent care, and this is what the urgent care said, Melissa. She said, okay, I'm going to put some stitches in it. Okay, I'm just going to put one stitch in it. Okay, you're okay with that? I'm like, yeah. Yeah, I'm good with that. I've had stitches before, but I've never had stitches in my fingertips. And she said, I'm going to deaden it. Are you okay? I said, yeah. I said, you're scaring me. She said, this may be a little painful. I said, how painful can it be? And she stuck that needle in the tip of my finger. I almost jumped out of the chair, and matter of fact, grandsons, I screamed. I said, ah! She said, are you okay, sir? Are you okay? I said, no. I said, that hurt. She said, I know. I'm just so sorry. And then she said, can I do it one more time? I said, go ahead. I almost drew tears. But that wound, y'all, left a scar. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? It left a scar. To be scarred means a mark that is left by a wound. It means that it's healed. It means that it was sore, but now it's healed. A scar can also be defined as a lasting after effect of trouble. Watch this. Especially psychological injury resulting from a trauma. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So scars can be physical, but scars can be mental. Watch this. Faith and experience teaches us how to overcome when storms arise. They show us how to move beyond the scar. When storms out there occur, there's always a potential for fear to step in. Watch this, y'all. It's always a potential. Fear is interesting to me because fear has a paralytic nature. Fear can freeze you in place. It appears that as we get older, it appears that we become smarter and more educated. But as we get older and smarter and more educated, we become more fearful. Okay, I'm just going to talk to somebody. Sometimes we fear the unknown. It's an unknown path, and so we're afraid of it. Unknown instruction, so we become afraid of it. Have you ever noticed that the older you get, fear rises up, and you find yourself speaking and talking about things that might happen, even though they never have happened? Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Don't drive over there. You're driving too fast. You're driving too slow. You're going to get in an accident. I ain't never been in an accident, but you could get in one. As you get older, you say, why? Because I've been in an accident before. When First Lady was my girlfriend, we was driving down the street coming driving back to Ferris, and we spun out in an ice storm. And every time it gets cold and every time it begins to rain or drizzle, Deacon Mason, I think about when I was 19 years old, spinning around on the freeway. Y'all not saying nothing to me. Scars. It's a scar. It's been healed for a long time, but it's a scar. When we were younger, we were willing to experience new things. We were willing to experience new people without reservation. But as we get older, we may say, I'm too old to make new friends. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The fishers were experts. They were expert fishers. They understood water. They understood storms. And they understood fear. They understood how to navigate through tough terrain. The fishermen knew when it was time to relax, but they also knew when it was time to be afraid. I believe that Jesus wanted the disciples to get used to exercising their faith. I believe that all of us, the wounds that we have, there are examples of us learning how to exercise our faith to understand that this too shall pass, that everything is going to be all right. It's a storm. What season the virus has taught many of us is that no matter what happens, no matter what comes our way, all we have to do is exercise our faith in the midst of the storm. Hallelujah. Especially in times that are unfamiliar to us, we got to rely on our faith. Somebody put that in the chat. Say, you got to rely on your faith. Rely on your faith. Romans 1 and 17 says, for the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, for it is written that the just shall live by faith. Hebrews 11 and 1 say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Ed Thomas says that faith is having a confident attitude toward God and his will for your life. Faith. Faith calling things that be not as though they were. Faith. This too shall pass. I'm going to get through this. Hallelujah. Who would ever thought 17 months ago that you would bring groceries in the house and disinfect your groceries? Huh? But by faith, God taught us how to survive. Why? Faith has substance. Faith is acting on what you believe. We can make it. Watch this. Number one, write this down. It's not my doubt. I'm going to talk to somebody today. It's not my doubt. Write that in the chat. Put that in the chat, Sue Moore. It's not my doubt. The same day he said unto them, let us pass over to the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him and he was asleep in the ship. And there were some other ships. How many people know that folks are born with a believing nature? Children just believe. But then all of a sudden, doubt creeps in. Are y'all all right? Wave at me. Let me know y'all still out there. All right. Doubt creeps in. Adam and Eve were believers, but then they were introduced to doubt. Preach, Thomas. Most of us were introduced to doubt by somebody else. Maybe a school teacher introduced you to doubt. Maybe your friend introduced you to doubt. Maybe your parent. Maybe you got one of them parents that just doubt everything. Close relative, always doubting something. Close relative. Sometimes even religious folks. Elder Blackwell, you with me, man? You still you got my back? Sometimes even religious folks will cast doubt, always lifting up the devil. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. Religious folks, are we? The devil gonna do the devil. What? I used to tell a joke years ago about the devil in church, and they had a testimony service, and they was in testimony service, and the devil snuck in the church, and the devil was in the back of the church crying. Somebody went back there and asked the devil, said, what you back here crying for, devil? He said, because everybody up there lying on me. Everybody always talking about the devil. And so doubt creeps in. Folks couldn't do this, and they couldn't do that. You couldn't achieve, they couldn't achieve things themselves, so then they turn around and put the doubt on somebody else. Somebody say, it's not my doubt to carry. Come on, touch yourself on the chest and say, it's not my doubt to carry. Not carrying somebody else's doubt. Jesus got inside the boat, and he said, let's go to the other side. He was tired, but he was full of faith. He taught the multitude all day long, so he laid down and he went to sleep. Sometimes when preachers, when we're operating under the anointing of God, we can do a lot of different things, but then when that anointing is gone, we go home and pass out. We fall fast asleep. Why? Because God's supernatural energy is on you, and then once that supernatural energy is gone and you just back operating in a manly sense, you feel the tiredness. Jesus went into the boat with the disciples, and there, the verse 36 said, they were there with little ships. In other words, they were there with some others who were not yet finished getting the word. Boy, I wish I had some witnesses, y'all. If I had some witnesses, they'd be shouting on that. Some folk that said, I'm not yet finished getting the word. There were some people that were still hungry from the word, so they came up in their own boats. There were some other boats, and all they wanted was more of the word. They're like many of you that say, I just want some more of the word. I just want to just encourage and increase my faith. They believed that the word was true. They believed that there was power in the word. They believed that if they just hung around a little bit longer. Boy, I wish I had some witnesses that just could testify to hanging around just a little bit longer. Somebody came here today because you know that God has a word for you. You came in here today because you believe in the power of his word. This is the season for those folks that just want a word from God. Somebody say, I just need a word from God. Facebook or face-to-face, just get a word from God. God told me to tell somebody, just hang around a little bit longer. Come on, write that in the chat. Just hang around a little bit longer. Come on, John Bishop. I ain't seen you in a long time. Hang around just a little bit longer. How many people know that it doesn't matter what ship you're in? Just one word from God can change your life around. So all you need is just one word. One word of God can change the whole course of your venture. Somebody said they just wanted a word. I remember I heard a preacher say years ago that we all came to America on different ships. Some even came on slave ships. But I heard the preacher say, but we all in the same boat now. How many people know that COVID-19 taught us something? It taught us that we're all in the same boat. Everybody was getting COVID. Black folk, white folk, Hispanic folk, Asian folk. They was all getting it. Come on, somebody. Why? Because we was all in the same boat. But when we all get together and begin to praise God, big things can happen. The Bible says that one can put 1,000 to flight and two can put 10,000 to flight. If we all get together, we can begin to lift up the name of Jesus. Things can begin to happen. We can get rid of this thing. I'll pray for you and you pray for me and watch God change things. Anybody believe that? Anybody believe that God is still a miracle working God? Anybody believe that God can that God still sits high and looks low? Anybody believe that God can still bless you even though you got scars? Somebody say thank you, Jesus. Number two, you got to keep the faith. I'm about to get up out of here. Number two, keep the faith. Verse 37 says, and there arose a great storm of wind. The waves beat into the ship, and now the ship was full. But Jesus was at the lower part of the ship, and the Bible says that he was asleep. Whenever we step out on faith, at some point, listen to me, y'all. At some point, Melissa, there's going to be a storm. Man, I got to tell, somebody ought to understand. At some point, there's going to be a storm. Sometimes the storm is more vicious than other storms. The severity of the storm is what makes the difference. Whatever God is calling you to do, it's not going to come without opposition. Did y'all hear what I said? When God is calling you to do something, opposition is going to come. All assignments from the Lord come with opposition. Boy, y'all ain't said nothing. See, I heard from God. Oh, okay, all right, here it comes. Huh? I heard from God. God told me to do X, Y, and Z. All right, well, here it comes. Here come what, bro, pastor? Opposition. Opposition comes with promotion, with transfer, with a new team, with a new school. Opposition is coming. For some, it might be a small level of opposition. But for others, it might be a great level. That's how you know it's God. Because you're always going to get some pushback. I said, that's how you know it's God. Because somebody is going to push back. Y'all ain't saying nothing. If there's no opposition, then there's a good chance that it's not a God assignment. Or if there's no opposition, just wait a little while. Just wait a little while. Just wait just a little bit. Watch this. If there's no opposition right now, just wait a little bit. Opposition is going to come. Opposition doesn't mean that it's going to be a failure or it's going to be sure failure. But opposition means that when it comes and you start to feel the opposition, that's the time when you say, Lord, here it is. I was expecting it. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Understand something, that storms might leave scars, but God. I'm almost done, y'all. Storms might leave scars, but God. Don't panic. Come on, say it out loud. Say, don't panic. Write that on the screen, Drew Lindsay. Don't panic. Jesus is in the house. Man, I feel like preaching now. I remember when Lazarus, who was Jesus' friend, I remember when Lazarus died, and the Marys and Mary and Martha, they got upset. And they said, if you would have been here, he would not have died. How many people know that Jesus said, wait a minute. Jesus stepped in. He went in and he called Lazarus by name. And this is what he said. This is what he said, read it. He said, Lazarus, come forth. I believe that he had to call Lazarus by name, because if he would have said, come forth, everybody that was dead would have got up. Why? Because he got all power in his name. I need to tell somebody today that now is not the time to panic. Don't panic. Don't panic. The Lord is going to step in. It's just a matter of time. Somebody say that. Put that on the screen. It's just a matter of time. Come forth, my brother. It's just a matter of time. Come forth, my sister. It's just a matter of time. Your help is not on the way. Your help has already arrived. It's just a matter of time. I wish I had some experienced fishermen today that understand something. When you drop that pole in the water, it's just a matter of time. Fish gonna be biting any minute now. It's just a matter of time. I wish I had some experienced folks in the house that understand that there's going to be some stormy nights, but it's just a matter of time. My little granddaughter is here today, and my little granddaughter came in. She had a little lantern. She grabbed my little lantern. She said, what's this, Papa? I said, it's a lantern. She said, what's this lantern for? I said, because when the lights go out, we're going to have some lights in the house. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because guess what? Watch this, Deacon Mason. It's just a matter of time. The power will go out. It's just a matter of time. And when you're not prepared, you're in the dark. But when God gives you some wisdom, you know where the flashlight is. You know where all the lamps are at. Come on, somebody. You know where the candles are at. You ain't got to run out to mire. It's just a matter of time. Anybody ever had to call on God in the midst of your storm? I'm about ready to go home. Watch this. Mark 4:39 says, he arose and he rebuked the wind and the sea. This is what he said. He said, peace, be still. I'm getting ready to go home. Jesus hears panic in their voices and his disciples, and he arises and he questions their faith. How many people know that I'm not satisfied with just being as I am? I need God to take us to a higher level. Anybody say, Lord, it don't matter how you bless me. Somebody say that out. Say, Lord, it don't matter how you bless me. However you bless me. Come on, say it out loud. Say, however you bless me, I'll be satisfied. How many people know that healed is healed? Y'all ain't said nothing. I said healed is healed. I could care less how he heals. The only thing that I care about is that he heals. It don't matter even when he heals. Yeah, I'm just waiting to see. I want to see when this scab going to come off. Listen, you ain't going to see that scab come off. You ain't going to see the healing take place. Healing is taking place even as you're looking at the scab. Come on, somebody. It don't matter how he's going to heal. It only matters that he heals. I don't care how the pain leaves. Just go. Somebody say, just go. Peace is peace. I don't care how. You have to move some folks out of my way. You can move this one out. You can move that one out. I don't care how you move folks out of my way, but peace is peace. Peace be still. Preach, Thomas. I'm going to preach. I'm going to do the best I can with what I got. I don't care who you use to bless me. All I care about is that you bless me. Y'all ain't saying nothing today. Somebody write in the chat, use your faith. Use your faith. Use your faith. I'm about to get out of here. Don't worry about how it's going to happen. Just understand that it's going to happen. Anybody believe that today? Did anybody come in here today understanding that it's going to happen? Can I just prophesy to somebody? It's going to happen. Don't worry about how it's going to happen. Don't worry about how the blessing is going to occur. Just believe that the blessing is coming. The Bible said that Jacob found himself in the midst of an angel. I'm about ready to go home. Jacob knew that the blessing was close. Can anybody sense that your blessing is close? If you can sense that your blessing is close, put your hands together. My blessing is close. Write in the chat, don't let go. It's close. I put it in your notes. Don't let go. It's close. Jacob found himself in a struggle. He found himself wrestling with the angel. And the Bible said, all night long, he wrestled with the angel. And the angel said to him, let me go. And Jacob said, I'm not going to let you go. not until you bless me. The angel pulled Jacob's hip out of socket. In other words, he left a scar. Jacob was in pain during the struggle, but he wouldn't let go. I stopped by to tell somebody today that it's going to be a struggle sometime. There's going to be an opposition sometime. But I stopped by to encourage somebody's heart and let you know, don't let go. Somebody's in pain today, but you're closer than you've ever been to healing in your life. Don't let go. That encounter left Jacob limping. He was walking around limping. Every time some people saw Jacob limping, they said, he's limping. But others looked at him and said, that limp ain't an ordinary limp. That limp is connected to a blessing. Boy, I wish I had some witness in this place today. I'm scarred, but I'm blessed. Jesus said, peace be still, and the sea obeyed him. How many people know that it's better than for the sea to obey you than to doubt the Lord? They call him Jesus because he is the Prince of Peace. I'm about ready to go home. They call him Jesus. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the bright morning star. He is the wheel in the middle of the wheel. He is my heart fixer. He is the mind regulator. He is the redeemer. And my redeemer lives. He is the burden bearer. Somebody say burden bearer. He's the mind regulator. He's the bridge over troubled water. He is my all in all. He is our everything. I'm not going to let go, not until you bless my soul. Touch your neighbor. Don't touch nobody. We can't touch nobody. Pastor got carried away. Don't touch nobody. Just say out loud, I'm scarred, but I'm still blessed. Hallelujah. I'm not in no mess. I'm just scarred. I got some scars. I got some bruises, but I'm still blessed. Every time I look at a scar, I see the blessing. Every time I look at opposition, I see the blessing. Touch somebody say out loud, say, I'm blessed. Say, I'm scarred, but I'm blessed. I'm not no mess. I'm just blessed. Amen. I'm just like everybody else. I've been through some things. I've been through some storms, but God has brought me through. Come on, the doors of the church are open. You come as a candidate for baptism. You come on your own Christian experience. If that's you, come on and come. Hallelujah. Come on, stand to your feet. I don't got no music to play you out. Elder Bell ain't here today. Hallelujah. All I have is just some words. Hallelujah. Scarred. Scarred. Liz Newberry. Scarred, but blessed. Scarred, but blessed. Hallelujah. They said that Jonah was in the belly of the whale for 3 days. And they said when Jonah came out of, come on, firstly, when Jonah came out of the belly of the whale, they said that the acid in the whale's stomach had scarred Jonah. And he was scarred. And so people came around to see Jonah to see the scars. To see the one that God had blessed by bringing him out of the belly of the whale. Amen. Hallelujah. If you need to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life, I need you to repeat this after me. Say, Father God, say, I thank you for blessing me. Say, Lord, you said in your word, if I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart, that I shall be saved. I confess you today as Lord and Savior of my life. Come into my heart. Holy Spirit, take control of me today in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, y'all. Let's give God some praise in this place today.
Yeah. Glory.
Amen.
We're
going to have to get some of them old school funeral fans. You ever seen them old school funeral fans? We have to get them old school funeral fans and put some stuff on the back of the funeral fans, like a smiley face. And so when y'all smile, y'all just lift it up like that. Hallelujah. Have some big hallelujahs. Maybe have on one side have a lady jumping and shouting. Right? Maybe on the other side have one of the deacons praying on his knees. Y'all know. Man, we have to get creative.
Amen. Praise
Amen.
The Lord.
What you got for
wow,
us, Lord?
What a powerful, powerful message today. Truly, truly, God has our back. Amen. He's got us, saints of God. Just powerful, powerful.
Scarred.
Yes.
But blessed.
Yes. I thought about that one song. I may have some scars, but yeah. I'm healed.
But I'm healed.
I'm healed.
Amen.
Amen.
How many people know that's a true statement? Amen. Listen. Don't. You know, give me somebody. I remember years ago. This been years ago. I remember years ago. You know, I was listening to this couple, Deacon Mason. I was listening to this couple, and they were talking about marriage. They're talking about marriage, and they were trying to act like they was experts on marriage.
Okay.
And they had been married like 3 years.
Oh boy.
I said, they ain't got no scars.
Amen.
Deacon Blackwell,
Amen.
Know what I'm talking about. Yes. They ain't got no scars, Deacon.
Yes.
They ain't been through nothing. They ain't been through nothing. They ain't been through lean times. They ain't been through nothing. They trying to tell people how to be married. I said, you ain't got no scars. Let me turn something else. Let me turn to something else. Amen.
Amen. You looking for somebody with some experience.
I need somebody with some experience.
Amen.
And that's with in the life of the believer, I need some folks. I'm just preaching to some folks that have experiential Christianity.
Amen.
Some
Amen.
People that's been through some stuff, Matt Blackwell.
Yes.
They've been through some stuff. And they say, you know what? I went through that, and God brought me.
Amen. Amen.
Huh? You start talking to people that ain't been through. Oh, we got to go. Ain't talking about people ain't been through nothing.
Amen.
Yeah. The Lord will. What you been through? Nothing. Okay, find me somebody that the Lord. Find me somebody that the Lord.
That they got a real testimony,
they got some testimony,
right?
Huh?
Yes.
They was dead and they came back alive.
Amen.
Okay, I want to talk to you.
In the belly of the whale.
Come
Amen.
On. Amen.
Amen. I do want to cover. We have so many young people here today, and it's just the Lord put it on my heart.
Yes.
I just praise God. Young people, I am so proud of you.
Yes.
You are amazing. You have done a wonderful job with
yes.
this pandemic. You have been in school sometimes. You have been at home sometimes. You have had to learn in different environments. And I just want you to know how proud I am of you. And I want you to know that God is with you every step of the way. He
yes.
will continue to be with you.
Yes.
You will do great in school this school year. And you can expect God to just continue to bless your lives. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give God some praise for our young people.
So proud of you.
How many people know?
God is pleased with you, young people. He's pleased with
you. Older people know that what they've been through is a scar. Amen. We never went through what they went through.
Amen.
Never. Never.
Amen.
Had to stay at home and go to school with your mama? You got to stay home and go to school with mama and them?
And then
yeah. mama and them trying to act like they know how to do math. Mama and them know they don't know how to do no math. Well, okay, we're going to figure it out together, baby. Oh, Lord.
Amen.
Hey,
amen.
We listen, young people, yes, you have been through a lot.
Yes.
And God has brought you all. You got a testimony. When you get to be our age, you will look back over your life and say, I remember.
You will be in the history books.
Yes.
The books that you're reading right now for history, you will be in those history books going forward. I'm just so proud of you.
Amen.
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 Amen. So have an awesome, awesome school year.
I got about 2 minutes. Young people, lift your hands. Just all my young people in here, lift your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus,
yes.
Father, we cover them today.
Yes, God.
We cover them in school, Lord God.
Thank
we
you.
Cover them, Lord God, on the playground.
Yes,
we
even
cover
our Facebook
them coming
kids. Thank
to school
you, God.
And going from school.
Yes, Lord.
We pray for even our Facebook students today,
yes.
Lord God. I pray that this year will be the best school year ever.
Yes.
And Father God, I pray for the parents, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for getting them through.
Amen.
And I pray that this will be their best year.
Yes.
Ever.
Yes.
And we give you glory, honor, and praise right now in advance. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless y'all. Amen.
Glory.
Well, that's all
glory.
We have today. May the good Lord keep him in heaven and smile upon you. That is our prayer. God bless you all. Thank y'all for coming. God bless y'all.
Have an awesome week.
Listen, don't forget to share this with somebody on Facebook. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.